scurrier, grumbling of diaphragm, and barely squeaking through limited potions every 10 hours. I was ABC Robotnik into a linear frenzy futile. Oh man, I was stiff from working. I got bleary from the quick dysentery of cable TV. I took those vacations anyway. 2 o'clock, 3 a.m., 4 a.m. Movies till dawn. I was needle-headed, hammer-threaded. I was called lazy and incompetent by tyrants bellowing ballpark bottom-line figures. I was pointlessly slandered. I was called illegal through vague and harsh megaphones. I was clouded as a loser on satellite dishes, coast to coast. I was force-fed the gruel of scapegoats on these cold, cold winter nights. I ate my supper standing up, and my lunches leaning forward. And for as long as I can remember, I ate no breakfast at all. I was a hungry man. I was a tired woman. It was tribulation that still held my sugar coffee. And even the whiskey left me cold in the rain's arena. Never mind what I did. A little of everything took my months. A lot of other things took my years. I lifted stone, hammered wood, wheeled taxi cabs, balanced plates, pumped petrol, counted paper, painted walls, saluted fools, cleaned vomit, washed dishes, changed tires, climbed ladders, taught children, took temperatures, picked food, paved roads, listened hard, and gave advice, and prayed for peace, but none came. There was always somebody nearby, lurking, wearing those clean fingernails and those button-down suits, adding and subtracting, using their mathematical weapons on my weakened defenses. There was always somebody nearby, shouting at me. Effort is not enough. Bleeding is not enough. I was not enough. There was always somebody younger, and through no fault of their own, dumber, waiting in the background, waiting in line just behind me. Unemployment number 8776. They're vaguely itchy, sitting behind me, waiting for me to collapse. There was always too many people to say no. No. Not enough people to say yes. Yes. And these things I have seen in my own time. So these days, I have learned to sing for myself. And my body, and my labor, and my future belongs to me now. I will work before I steal. I will steal before I beg. I will beg before I starve, and I will demand that anybody who foolishly lays claim over me read this poem first. Because you talked, they talked again, and now it's my turn.